Hi, today I'm here to speak about the commonly faced problem among old people, that is knee pain, or else osteoarthritis of the knees, what we call it as. There are a lot many reasons for the knee pain, but the osteoarthritis as such, it's a progressive degenerative disease of the knee joint where the patients come to us with severe pain in the knee. They have pain at night, they are not able to walk for longer distance, and they have finding difficulty climbing stairs up and down, and even they find difficulty getting up from a low-lying sofa. What is osteoarthritis? Osteoarthritis is a progressive degenerative disease of the knee joint. Now, knee joint, before I start speaking about the knee joint pain in detail, let me tell about the anatomy of the knee joint. The knee joint per se is made up of three bones. The upper bone is thigh bone, the lower bone is leg bone, that is the tibia, and the third bone is called as patella or as chip bone. There are three compartments in the knee joint. One is lateral compartment, the medial compartment, and the patellofemoral compartment. I have seen people coming to me with pain on the inner side of the thigh. That is basically because the pain is on the medial compartment. It is commonly seen in people who are obese, who are females, who are suffering with thyroid pain, and if they had some injuries in the young age, like fractures, it might be because of the ligamental injuries in the young age. What are the common symptoms they come to us? They come to us with saying that they have difficulty in walking for a distance about 500 meters. They are not able to walk in uneven surface. They will be able to manage themselves at home, that is on the plain surface. But on uneven surfaces, they will find it very difficult to walk even for a few meters. They have difficulty climbing stairs up and down. They are finding difficult to get up from a low-lying chair or a sofa. So what are the treatment aspects available nowadays for the knee pain? We get a simple investigations. We see for the tenderness, we'll see where the pain is originating from. And then the basic investigations, what we get is X-ray. In particular, we need to get a stress X-ray, and those X-rays will tell us what's the problem. So what basically is this osteoarthritis? As you can see here, when the space between this bone and this bone reduces, the bone touches the other bone. The moment the bone touches the other bone, the pain is severe. Naturally, as the nature says, there should be space between two bones. When two bones come together or they touch each other, the pain increases because bones are very sensitive as such. Now coming to the treatment aspect, or else I can classify the osteoarthritis in two categories. Basically, people who come to us, they are mainly into two categories. That is, one is varus knee, the joint is bent inside like this, and the valgus knee, the joint is bent this way. Almost like 80% of the people who are diagnosed to have osteoarthritis, they have varus knee. What are the treatment aspects available? We divide the joint pain into four categories. Grade 1, grade 2, grade 3 and grade 4. Grade 1, they'll have the treatment starts with simple exercises and simple supplements to the knee joint like calcium, vitamin, and that's it. Grade 2, we suggest to get injections done, that is hyaluronic acid. It's a joint supplement as such. Grade 3, with some meniscal injuries, the meniscus are washer-like structures which are present in between thigh bone and leg bone. So those meniscal tears, what we do is a keyhole surgery is done, the meniscus is repaired, the roots are repaired, and we do high tibial osteotomy, that is extra-articular procedure to correct the deformity, and sometimes we just do root repair and we do proximal fibular osteotomy. There is one more surgery called as proximal fibular osteotomy. With that simple surgery, we remove the small piece of bone from the thin bone called as fibula. By doing that thing, the mechanical axis can be corrected. The deformed mechanical axis can be corrected. Ultimately, gold standard treatment, if the patients have severe pain, the joint replacement surgery or total arthroplasty is what we suggest. The term when we use joint replacement surgery or surgery to the patients, they really get scared. When this surgery is done in a proper OT setup, by a very well trained surgeon, and when the physiotherapy support is much better and the whole team is involved, then the results are really very, very satisfactory. The surgery success rate, what we can say is Even the literature says it is almost like 90% plus if it is done by a properly trained surgeon and in a very well setup. So what is this joint replacement surgery? Joint replacement, what I could say it as, it is a joint resurfacement. As you can see here, the bones are like this. When the space between these two bones is reduced, the bones get worn out. In this, see, this bone, what we do is, I'll just show you, we just remove 2 mm of bone from the surface of this leg bone, just like around 2 to 8 mm of bone, and in the similar fashion, even at the femoral side, we just remove around, we'll just give a shape to the bone, to the thigh bone, that is around 2 mm of the bone is removed. We put a cap like this, it's a knee cap, we just push a cap like this, and on the tibial side also, on the other side also, we just put this metal with a plastic substance and we reduce it. Once this is done properly, this is promised to be, this gives a results, this will give pain relief to the patients for almost like 10 to 15 years is what the least what we claim if it is done properly and even maintained properly by the patients. What does this maintenance says? Maintenance says that you have to just keep walking after the surgery, you have to strengthen your muscles around the thigh bone and leg bone and do some stretch exercises and be away from the infections.